Okay, so how's it going, y'all? In this particular video, I'm going to show you guys a simple scalping strategy that you can use to trade Forex pairs. Now, if you look at it right here, I'm currently scalping USDGPY. Now, you guys are also taking the trade with me. The Telegram group, that is where I post in the trades that I take. So the signals out there are basically free, so you can go ahead and check that out for yourself. So in case you want to get that extra boost, that extra signal, whatever, go ahead and join the Telegram group and take the same trades that I take. So with that being said, let me go ahead and show you guys the strategy I'm using right here, right and now. Now, before we even get to the strategy, I want to correct one thing. Now, the best trading platform to use out there is MetaTrader 5. Now, if you're using to MetaTrader 4, I'm sure you want to make your life much more easier by going to MT5, because there are very awesome features on that MT5. So you could basically, I don't want to go ahead and explain that. Now, if you check whenever I'm trading or if I'm sharing a screenshot on Telegram, you know, to show you guys what I'm looking at in the market, you basically see this. Now, I don't want you guys to look at it that I'm just only an indicator type trader. I'm an indicator type trader plus a price action trader. So I trade price action too. So in price action, what I'm looking at is support and resistance. And what I'm also looking at is price reaction. What we're going to do right here is that we're going to remove all the indicators on here. Now, one thing I'll advise is for you to go to the higher time frame of the current time frame you're in. So if you trade like the 5-minute time frame, what you have to do is that you have to go to the 1-hour time frame. Now, if you're trading like the 15 minutes time frame, you can look at the 1-hour time frame, you can still look at the 1-hour time frame, and you can look at the 4-hour time frame. So why am I saying you should go to the higher time frame? Now, is to get the general perspective of the market, because when you're in the higher time frame, you could be like, okay, the overall direction of what I'm expecting is like a buy, the overall direction of what I'm expecting is a sell. So what I'm going to do right here, because I'm using the 1-hour time frame, I'm going to go to the daily time frame. Now, from EURUSD, we are seeing basically sells. We see that the market is in a downtrend. Now, as I've gone into EURUSD daily time frame, I know what I'm expecting more of in the market. So once I've already noticed all this, this right here is when I add in my indicator. So I'll go ahead and add in the 2 moving averages, that is the 25 moving average. So for those that are asking me, the shift is 0, the method is simple, the apply is to close, the levels, you don't need to add any level, the time frame, all time frame, that is if you're in MT5 to show this, then you can pick the color to be blue and hit done. So the second moving average I'm gonna add in here is the nine moving average. So I'm going to make this the 9 moving average, and I'm going to change the color to be red. The 9 moving average, you have the 25 moving average. So basically I'm covered. Now, whenever price is at the 9 moving average, or whenever price is following the lead of the 9 moving average, you could see some parts. When price touches the 9 moving average, it goes down. Price touches the 9 moving average, it goes down. Price touches the 9 moving average, it goes down. This is trying to tell me that the sales in the market is active. The sales in the market is basically active. So this is what the 9 moving average actually tells me. Now, at this point right here, what the 25 moving average means is the market is buying, you know, but it's not showing us active buys, but it just shows us that the market is buying. So let's just say in the case of a huge retracement, and we still want to be sure that the market is still in that sell position, I can basically check if price is still below that 25 moving average, then I'll know that, okay, the market is still in the sells. You understand? So that's why I basically use the 9 and the 25 moving average. So this is where some part of price action traders actually get lost. So when they draw in their trend line, they'll be like, oh, price has broken the trend line, price has already broken the trend line, and it's coming in with heavy candles, and they'll be like, okay, it's time to buy up the market type of a thing. But because they don't have this moving average we have on here, they might feel like, okay, price is buying, it's buying, price has converted to a buy, but it's still in the sell position. So this 25 basically tells me whether how active the market is. The second indicator I have on here is the stochastics. Let me add that one in. The settings for the stochastics is the key percent period is 10, the D percent period or the percent D period is 6, slowing is 6, price field slowing slash high, method simple, levels 20 and 80. The only thing you have to change is the stochastic oscillators. So why I added the stochastic right here in the market is due to timing. Now let me tell you guys the secrets about the stochastic. Now the stochastic tells you when a retracement can likely happen, tells you when a trend can likely happen, and it throws out suspicion of an upcoming trend. So this is exactly what the stochastic does. You can see right here, let me show you guys this point now. You can see right here that the stochastic raised that suspicion of
an upcoming retracement in the market. We can see right here that price is above the red moving average. We can see that price is basically above the blue moving average. But if you could notice something from the stochastic, we could see that the stochastic was at the 80 mark. So at this point, the stochastic was already raising that suspicion that there could be a retracement happening. So at that point, when I'm holding a trade, like when I'm buying EURUSD, I don't need to be surprised that, okay, this type of retracement is going to happen, because I've already seen it from the stochastic, you understand? What I'll do is that I'll make price above the red moving average, you know, back to back with the red moving average, that the trend is actually active and stuff like that. So let's say if I took my entry, you know, right here, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to put my stop loss right here, you understand? Then once price hit my stop loss, I've already secured profit, because it's actually like a trailing stop, you understand? If you could look right here, we could see that the stochastic actually raised that suspicion that something might happen, you know, a retracement might happen. But in this case, what that suspicion was meaning is a new trend in the market. Now, how to know what the suspicion is, you know, giving you is knowing how it reacts to the moving average, you understand? That is the most important thing. Now, you can see right here, when this suspicion was raised, we can see that price is below the 9 moving average and it's below the 25 moving average. Now, if you remember what I said about price being below the 25 moving average, all your biases about buys, the market going up, should end there. Now, what you should basically be looking at from that point is sales in the market. So now you want to be keeping close watch of the 9 moving average, because remember what we said about the 9 moving average? It shows when the trend is active. 9 moving average is for back-to-back movement. 25 moving average is, oh, the market is buying. Okay, yeah, basically, I know. Now, if you want to get a better understanding of this, you can go ahead and watch any video of me trading, or simply you can join the Telegram group. There I get to give you signals. So if you've not yet fully understand this, or you know, this whole thing, you can go to the Telegram group. I post your free signals. So just right there, you can go ahead and take the same chase that I take. So with that being said, I hope you guys did like this video. Hit the like button if you're not part of the family. Hit the red subscribe button. And with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the next one.